Hello YouTube. Another installment. Don't know if this is gonna make the YouTube channel or not, but hey, whatever. We're gonna try, right? Now here's the crazy thing. I've never been on these roads before. I think I know how to get back where I need to go, and I'm low on gas, which is ridiculous. Well, not really low, but half the tank. And it's kind of like, okay. So I'm going to take this next portion over here a little bit gently. No breaking any records here on the speed. Just because I'm low on gas and I need to get back into town. So this will be another just like video blog of me talking and you guys listening and tuning in and me riding back into where I need to go. I'm hoping you guys are appreciating the beautiful scenery, because I know I am. Those guys are just gonna like park there and go fishing. That is savagely raw right there. That is just savage. Yeah, we know no one's, we're just gonna park right here and throw our poles out. Yeah. I saw a fish jump. We're just gonna go fishing real quick. Okay, so when I came down this road, I had a little bit carry speed and my mental is going like, my mental like scare factors are going like, dude, take it easy. Now I'm coming back and I'm trying to go a little bit slower. My scares, you know, my mental isn't going like, my mental alarms are not going off. So you can tell that my pace is different the first time coming here and the second time coming back. Totally different. And if you guys are the type of guys that need me to go fast and try to kill myself to be on my channel, I'm sorry guys, this is not what I'm about. But there's other channels out there for you. Oh yeah, they're all over the place. If you want to come on a channel and have a good time and relax a little bit and watch some good writing, I'm your man. Yep, absolutely. If you want to come and see some wheelies and endos and jumps and near-death experiences and wrecks every Wednesday, not me. I just don't do that stuff. And it's not that I'm not like, you know, I haven't done dumb things in my life. Oh yeah, I've done dumb things. I like walking. I need my body. I'm an archer. I like to shoot archery. I like doing stuff. And my wife's pretty important to me. And my life is important to me. And my family and everything else. So, I mean, I'm just grateful that I can be on two wheels, to be honest. I mean, I thought I lost my two-wheel card from my wife, from Mrs. Rhino, like a couple years ago. I couldn't keep my promise. I couldn't keep, everywhere I went was over 100 miles per hour. And she made me look her in the eyes and say, all right, promise me you will not go over 100 miles per hour. And I was like, all right, I took that vow hell quick. Yeah, I promised her. Right. Uh-uh. And then just 600 was like, psych, dude, we're going 100 miles per hour like in second gear, fool. How the hell are you gonna keep your promise to your life, man? Mike was like, nope, not today. Remember having that conversation? So I had this silver Ninja 600RR. I love that bike. Had some Pirelli Rosso 3 tires on it. It was amazing. I mean, the bike was sticky. Tar paper, do anything on it. Felt fantastic. going through like a 60 mile per hour sweeper, leave at 120 miles per hour. I'm like, I don't know, like not even close to being maxed out on a lean angle. I mean, not even leaned over. The bike was just like, just stuck to the ground. It was awesome. I remember that conversation. I came home, looked my wife in the eyes. Well, she has two eyes, not one eye. I mean, come in, it's not like she had one eye. Anyway, I looked her in the eyes, and I said, babe, we gotta sell the bike. And she looked at me like, why? Well, I can't keep this bike under 100. I can't even keep it under 120. That's just cruising. So she said, okay. Next day, the bike went on Craigslist, and that was the end of that story. And there went one of my mistresses. I had to sell her. When I was off two-wheel, then I got a cruiser instead, which was a Suzuki Boulevard. It was an okay bike. Needed six gear. I mean, I think that the lack of six gear was kind of silly. But the bike kept me under 80. I can tell you that 85 was like the max. I think I tried 90 once, and then the bike made a loud noise and didn't go anywhere, like, you know, typical Harley fashion. So yeah, it just didn't, like, it went, and it just, like, I think it went like 83, and I was like, oh, okay, well, the bike's done. But then, you know, we both rode, you know, she got on the back of the bike and we rode together, and it was fun, and we had headsets and we talked to each other, and it was cool, actually. It was a good experience. And then I needed the money and I sold the bike. That bike name was Blackstar, actually. I bought it from a guy that was like taller than me, believe it or not. It does happen. There's guys out there who are really monsters. Actually, he had been a pretty good sparring partner for me in mixed martial arts. He was 6'7", about 280 pounds. I was like 6'3", at 260 pounds. So we'd have been a pretty good sparring match. Like if we wanted to fight and do jiu-jitsu together. He used to play hockey. The guy looks like he was like, you know, built like a, like an ox man, you know, like some Viking. But his bike was perfect for me. Like the handlebar position was fabulous. I didn't have to change nothing. I mean, everything on it was like ergonomically set up for me, and it was too tall for Mrs. Rhino, but for me, it was perfect. And I was like, yeah, even the seat was good and everything was fantastic. He tried to have the carburetors rejetted, but that didn't work out. Like I said, I sold the bike, and here I am. And then years later, I didn't think I was going to get on a motorcycle again. You know, I thought, well, I'll just buy like a Mustang and that would be my fast thing. And I did. I do have a Mustang. Absolutely. It's pretty fast. It's fun. And then I got on two wheels. And I'm happy to be back. As cool as the Mustang is, being on two wheels is way better for me. But there's things that the Mustang, there's things I take from two wheels to the Mustang. Absolutely. Like, I don't charge the turns in the Mustang. I do good throttle control. It's nice. It's really nice. Now, there's a safety recall on the motorcycle right now. It's supposed to be a bracket for the gas tank. I'm not supposed to be driving her. I'm not supposed to be driving gray wind. But today's too beautiful. I need to get ready for a big clinic I have coming up really soon. I'm super excited for the clinic. Keith Cobb's going to be there. And I'm going to try to get some as much footage as I can. I want to interview him. But here's the problem, and this is a legit problem. People don't understand. I have like 20,000 views and 100 subscribers. That's good. I'm making money at YouTube. I'm actually finally making a couple bucks. But here's the problem, though. Like, one day, I want to get, like, a media pass so I can go out, interview people, do reviews. Stuff I've already been doing on my channel right now, like reviews. I've been practicing, working on that, trying to get things set up where I can actually get in the position where I can do reviews. But here's the problem. I don't have the subscribers. And YouTube doesn't care about, I mean, YouTube cares about views because views is where the money's at. But if you had to tell somebody, hey, I want to interview you. And they say, all right, cool. How many subscribers do you have? Oh, I only have 100, but I have like 100,000 views. Oh, I don't care. And another guy comes up to him, hey, I want to interview you. Yeah? How many subscribers do you have? Oh, I have like 30,000 subscribers. And how many views do you have? 20,000 views. Oh, I don't care, but 30,000 subscribers is good. And that guy's going to get the interview. And that's the reason why I need to figure out how to get more subscribers. It's not because I want to. I need them. You know, they're good to have. But eventually, I want to go to like the SHOT Show. And I want to go to shows, and I want to go to certain shows across the country in a couple years, and I need subscribers for that. I do. That way, when I tell somebody, hey, I'm Rhino Dan, and I'm with Rhino Dan, like YouTube channel, my Rhino Dan Media Productions, whatever. Got Tier 1 Defense. We go out and do, you know, airsoft reviews, different things. My audience trusts me. And I have like 20,000 subscribers. Are you down? Sure. Here you go, sir. There's your subscribers. Awesome. Thank you. And I can do the video. I can do the interview. Just like I want to interview Keith Code. And I was thinking about that today. Like, crap. If I go up to Keith Code and go, hey, I have this YouTube channel. It's growing. And I got people checking me out. And YouTube's actually helping me get, like, be noticed and discovered. And I'm getting, like this last month, I got, like, 3,500 views, which is more than a lot of people have been getting, like, total for the last, like, months. And I go up and I want to get, like, a video, an interview with him. Because I do want to interview Keith Code. I do. Just like I want to interview Doc Juan, who gives, like, free motorcycle clinics in my area. I totally want to do that. For a lot of different reasons. Because he gives free motorcycle clinics of Keith Coe's material. Give it gas again. There you go. Mental. Gas. Yeah. Anyway, back on topic. So he gives free motorcycle clinics for free of Keith Coe's material. And he became one of Keith Coe's instructors. Gas. All right, there we go. Giving it gas. And so, but for... my channel has a lot of new riders in it. I don't have all the answers. All I'm doing is just taking Keith Coe's material and adapting it for myself and doing my best. But Doc Juan actually teaches his material the way it's supposed to be taught. I'm just doing it my interpretation. So when you get it from me, it's just what works for me. It may not work for you, but it's what I took from it and what works for me. When you learn it from Doc Juan, it is Keith Coe's material, like word for word. And he gives it out for free. And I want to do an interview and throw them up on my channel. So all these other guys that have R3s and they come, because they come to my channel for R3s and different things. And then come in there and like, wow, this guy is like, if you're in the Bay Area, there's a lot of us in the Bay Area. Come and check out this guy and go to his motorcycle clinic. It's for free. All right, crap in the road. All right. Man, I hate these tires. What I'm saying is that it'd be a good thing to do. And you know, to get him more people and, you know, just to really promote. That's all I'm saying. So I need subscribers. No, I lose subscribers, which, you know, that happens, whatever, bummer. Boo. But I understand people come and go, especially if they come for the cat videos and they only post up a couple of them. I get you. Thanks for subscribing. They'll come as they come. It's hard because my two cats are adorable, but they're monsters. They do what they want to do when they want to do it, and my camera's never around. Like, I need to like record the GoPro and have it recording at the house, but there's not enough camera, like not enough camera life, and just record these guys and see what I get. Cause I know they're being hooligans when we're gone. I know, we have evidence. Come home, the house is thrashed. Then they're like looking at us like, oh yeah, meow, 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 I'm so innocent. No, you're not. You guys did this. But I don't have any video evidence of them doing it. And if I did, I'd throw it on YouTube and see, look, my cats might look adorable, but they're like, they're monsters in training. Man, this road is really good. They take good care maintenance of this road. They really do. They made it really easy. I mean, this is like a Harley Davidson paradise right here. If you have like a cruiser bike and you're on a Harley bike, this is your, these roads are for you. No floorboard scraping, no tight corners. I know I said it in a previous video, if that goes up, but it is so true. I mean, these are just fast freaking sweepers right here. The blind apex is not even all that bad. Looks like I'm doing pretty good on time too. And even this 25 mile per hour corner right here, it's not even really like a legit 25 mile per hour corner. If I could have gone through it like way quicker. Yep, so that safety recall is all about my gas tank coming loose and leaking gas and starting a fire in the bike and potentially killing me. Yay! Why am I in the bike? Because I'm stupid. Yay! No, I don't know. I figured I got this far with it and the bike's doing good. I can feel the engine vibration's not that bad. I don't, like, do anything really retarded on the motorcycle. I'm sure some guys have it, but they're probably in the wrong gear or engine vibrating up a lot. Usually this bike's pretty smooth, this parallel twin right here. Now some people like the thumpers, like the one motor, the one piston. Thump, 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 thump. I'm not a big thumper guy. I like the twins, I like the inline fours, parallel twins. I just like them. Everybody has their own liking though. I'm not gonna fault you for liking what you like. I'm just not a big thump, 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 thump. Guy. Or bang, 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 bang. Guy. I'm like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm one of those type of guys. I'm like, oh, hell yeah. This is a big guy. I'm not like a bang, 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 bang guy. But, you know, everybody's their own person. You can't tell them what they like. Not why there's like a million different types of motorcycles out there. There's one for somebody. Like fish in the sea for dating. There's somebody out there for something. For somebody. I already found my somebody. Mrs. Rhino. Oh yeah, she makes my heart go Oh yeah, like an inline four or a parallel twin, nothing like bang, 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 bang. But she never watches my videos, so she won't even get the reference. Man, what a beautiful day. Those jet skis are hauling. I don't think I've ever been on a jet ski. Concept's probably the same. Give it gas, and if you fly off, you're just in water. Probably hurts. Give it a little bit of brake here, letting the brake off nice and easy. Gonna get some gas. I'm in a really tall gear for this, but it's fine. Same thing, I just completely rolled off, pushing on the inside handlebar, nice little counter steer right there. Gonna give it some more gas, nice, gas is your friend. Nice little, nice movement on the bike. Rolling off a little bit, blind apex and a high gear, but that's fine because I'm not trying to go fast, just, you know, do it nice and smooth. Yeah. Batman smooth. But not Batman voice smooth. See, these guys knows what's up. These roads are for these guys. Just fast enough for them to have a good time, fast enough to scare them. You know, they are in bigger bikes, 1,000-pound motorcycles. You know, just enough to, like, oh crap, I'm riding, but damn, I'm not doing anything crazy. All right, I think I'm about to end this video here. All right, well, thanks for checking in. This is Right On In. Making weird voices today, having a good time. It's, like, great to be on a bike. Okay, this is a fast section. Be doing it one-handed for you guys. Yeah. Rolling off. One last time. Rolling back on. One-handed. I'm gonna turn off the camera with the other hand after I get to this turn. Rolling off. Gonna roll on. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. Yep. That's how it's done, folks. One-handed. With crappy tires. Anyway, thanks for checking in. Thanks for my subscribers. I love you guys. Need you guys. Appreciate you guys. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, please do. Don't hesitate. It's free. It's absolutely free. And if you don't like my content, don't watch it. There's something on there I'm sure you're going to like. That's why my channel works. I got something for everybody. I do. I really do. That's it. Thank you, guys.